Aliko Dangote is currently the wealthiest man in Africa. His net worth sits at over $10 billion. This does not mean he has that amount in his bank account, as it fluctuates time and again. But this means he has assets that will pay him hourly, weekly, or monthly. Imagining yourself in that position would be pleasurable for anyone. This is 3 trillion naira, 166 billion rand, 57 billion cedis, or 216 trillion dobras. But if you were somehow endowed as the wealthiest person in Africa, what would that be like? Or better yet, what will you do? That is what we'll discuss today on GreenClick. By the way, be a friend and subscribe. Click the notification button to get alerts and like the video to help us make more videos you love about our amazing continent. Let's dive in. This video is not like all others, as they usually try to answer the topic in question. In this video, we will try to understand what wealth is, how one gets there, and hopefully question you on your ideology on money, wealth, and life. So if you happen to be the richest person in Africa, with let's say 12 billion US dollars, higher chances are you were born into a middle class or a wealthy family, and you were able to use all necessary resources at your disposal to create more wealth. Africa is not really like the other areas of the world where anyone can make it. It takes a special kind of talent and luck to attain serious wealth in Africa. Again, we're not saying it's impossible for a poor person to become a billionaire by conventional methods. Having this much wealth would mean you have real estate that you're renting out. You would also have a business that provides a service in high demand, like telecommunications, construction, food, or medical services. Then you would also have shares in high-earning corporations that will be paying out hefty dividends based on the amount of shares you have in the companies. This certainly would not come overnight, as it would take most likely 30 years of your life to attain such wealth. In your life of wealth, you would have to deal with so many headaches, like how to distribute wealth to those who will always ask for money. Depending on which African country you live in, you would also have to have a significant amount of security around you. People would also treat you differently than normal people because of your status, and offers would also be thrown at you, as all of a sudden you will be a person of great influence. Forget the quiet life, you will not be able to go anywhere you want anyhow. If you had a hobby that involved outdoor physical activity or musical instrument, they would all have to be private, because wherever you go, people will watch your every move. Your family may also be subject to living a secretive life, as in some countries, kidnapping is a big thing. Money will not solve everything, but it will allow you to wake up whenever you want and focus on things that really give you a sense of purpose in life. Now that we have the factual representation of wealth, we can talk about the philosophical aspect of this scenario. What would you do if you were the richest African right now? With over $10 billion, what would make you happy? Would you just aim to make more? Or would you just enjoy life as it comes? Would you only invest in foreign markets? Or would you deploy your money to work for you in companies closer to home? Are you someone who believes strongly in family and lineage, prompting you to only add prestige to your family name? If that's the case, you would invest in a family business that will make your children and grandchildren inherit wealth forever. Or you'd be like Bill Gates and donate 90% of your wealth to charities. 90% of your wealth will still give you $1 billion to live off. Would you spend most of your money traveling the world? This earth is so big, you would learn about so many other cultures and experience a plethora of luxuries the world has to offer. Or are you a lover of people and you'd rather spend on lives instead? Would you lend your interest to middle class? The middle class determines the strength of the economy in a country, and investing in middle class jobs would improve the society. Or instead, you may sympathize with the poor class and invent jobs to improve the life of the poor. Or would you rather give your money to those who desperately need it in charitable organizations supporting the sick or the manipulated? Would you invest your time or employ people to improve education, the environment, or even the healthcare of your country or Africa? Or are you more likely to spend your wealth on missionary work, spreading God's words around the earth? Are you one that believes in YOLO and would splurge on the best that life has to offer, like expensive cars and diamonds? Or maybe you are a person of simple taste and would live a life of seclusion, because you know that everyone and their papa that knows you will ask you for a piece of the pie. There is also the underbelly of chaos to money, as one does not really understand that an influx of money can amplify who you are. If you love to give with little money, you would give way more money when you're rich. But on the other hand, if you are an alcoholic or you love to gamble before attaining wealth, you have a high chance of amplifying your alcoholism or gambling addiction. If you have a problem with being naturally happy, money may not fix the unhappiness. Wealth would not prevent natural disasters or death entering your circle. So has this video made you think about what you ultimately want in life? What would you do if you were the richest person in Africa? What questions would you ask yourself, and how would you act on it? Indulge us with comments below. We'd love to hear your story on this. If you'd like to be informed when we roll out new videos, give us a like to help us with the YouTube algorithm. Share this with a friend and drop a comment if you disagree or would like to request a video. Till then, brothers and sisters, Odabo.